Hello, beloved students. How are you? Fine? Preparing well? Okay. We are discussing inverse trigonometric functions, NCERT text, exercise 2, problem 6. Again, we will prove by two methods. Okay. To have your concepts clear. Okay. So, this is the data. Cos inverse of 12 by 13 plus sin inverse of 3 by 5. Equals to, we have to prove sin inverse of 56 by 65. Let us assume that cos inverse of 12 by 13 equals to alpha and sin inverse of 3 by 5 equals to beta. That means alpha should be in range of cos inverse, that is alpha belongs to closed interval 0 to pi, and beta must be in range of sin inverse, so beta belongs to closed interval minus pi by 2 pi by. From here cos alpha will be 12 by 13, sin beta will be 3 by 5. See, both alpha, cos alpha and sin beta are between 0 and 1. So this is first quadrant. So therefore, alpha and beta both belong to open interval 0 to pi by 2. Preparing right angle triangles, cos alpha 12 by 13. So this side will be 5 according to Pythagoras. So sin alpha will be 5 by 13. Sin beta is 3 by 5, so this side will be 4 according to Pythagoras. So cos beta will be equal to 4 by 5. Now see, here alpha plus beta, and we need sin inverse. So applying sin of alpha plus beta, that is sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta, putting the values, okay, sin alpha 5 by 13, cos beta 4 by 5, plus cos alpha, that is 12 by 13, and sin beta, that is 3 by 5. So this will be 20 upon 65 plus 36 upon 65. So finally 56 by 65, which is positive. Now from result 1, see, 0 less than alpha less than pi by 2 and 0 less than beta less than pi by 2. Adding these two, 0 plus 0 less than alpha plus beta less than pi by 2 plus pi by 2. So 0 less than alpha plus beta less than pi. So alpha plus beta may be in first quadrant or in second quadrant, but sin of alpha plus beta is positive. Okay. Similarly, here if we calculate, cos of alpha plus beta also will be positive. So alpha plus beta is positive, is in first quadrant. So alpha plus beta is between 0 to pi by 2. Okay. So we can say alpha plus beta equals to sin inverse of 56 by 65. So cos inverse of alpha is cos inverse of 12 by 13 plus sin inverse of 3 by 5 equals to sin inverse of 56 upon 65. Okay. Now method 2. Okay. Cos inverse x, we can use cos inverse x equals to tan inverse of root of 1 minus x square upon x. And you can remember it easily. See, imagine a rectangle triangle. Okay. X. Okay. Then you need 1, and then here it will be root of 1 minus x square. So from that you can easily say that cos inverse x equals to tan inverse of root of 1 minus x square upon x. Similarly, sin inverse x, you can imagine or you can remember tan inverse of x upon root of 1 minus x square. Now LHS equals to cos inverse of 12 by 13 plus sin inverse of 3 by 5. Okay, so equals to tan inverse of square root of 1 minus x square, that is 144 upon 169 divided by x, that is 12 by 13, plus tan inverse of x upon root of 1 minus x square. So see, 169 minus 144, that is 25, square root of it will be 5 upon 12, because denominators will be cancelled. Similarly here, 25 minus 9 is 16, square root of it is 4, so 3 by 4. Now multiplication of these two is less than 1. So if xy is less than 1, we should use tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y equals to tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Okay, so tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy, 20 plus 36, denominators will be cancelled. Before that here it will be 48 minus 15, so 56 by 33, tan inverse of. Now I have to convert tan inverse into sin inverse. This is the formula, tan inverse of x equals to sin inverse of x upon root of 1 plus x square. We can prove here only. Assume x as tan theta, then tan inverse of tan theta will be theta. If you put here tan theta upon square root of 1 plus tan square, that is square root of sec square, that is sec. Now tan upon sec, that will be sin. Sin inverse of sin theta will be equal to theta. So LHS equals to RHS. but we have to just use it here, okay? So tan inverse x equals to sin inverse of x upon square root of 1 plus x square. So 33 square will be here, and these denominators will be cancelled. So sin inverse of 56 upon 33 square plus 56 square, that will be 65 square. According to Pythagoras, it will be 65. Square root of 65 square will be 65. So sin inverse will be equal to 56 upon 65. Bye.